Good afternoon. My name is Alex. I'm working in the Federal University of São João del Rey. And in this video, I will talk how to perform virtual screening using Octopus software and our own molecular targets. And this project is supported by CNPq and FAPEMIG. I talked about the prepared ligands using RANMOPAC. Thus, in this video, we perform virtual screening using Octopus. Octopus is a platform that you have the targets. We have two databanks, BRANK is malaria molecular targets, and our own molecular targets. Okay, BRANK, all these targets belongs to Plasmodium falciparum. These three last molecular targets were created by our group using molecular modeling, comparative homology modeling approach. This one are molecular targets from Plasmodium falciparum, in general cancer, and we have some molecular targets for dengue. Please check our publication about these molecular targets. And as a tutorial video, I will perform virtual screening of these ligands, aspirin and indomethacin. Indomethacin, I got the structure from zinc. I will show how to prepare this structure. Okay, and for a virtual screening, I will use only two molecular targets to show how to prepare our molecular, our virtual screening. Thus, I have to change this file because this file has the standard binding energy. So I will take only the first two binding energy. Okay. And all these molecular targets prepare with AutoDoc tools, and you have parameterized grid box. This is the size, and we use the KOH exhaustiveness, which we set for 24, and in some cases 36. Okay. Here the PDB file format of aspirin. You can see the charge here of carboxylate group, and this is the zinc SMILE file. Use only SMILE file, okay? Don't use another source as MOL2. Thus, after you made the download from zinc, you use this command to generate the PDB file. You have to, I use Babel, and I use this keyword, and now I'm generating the indomethacin file. Okay, you can open the SMILE files in Marvin Sketch. It works very well too. Okay. Sorry. I have to change it. Make it. I generated the PDB file of Indometacin. It's here. You see the charge in the carboxylate group. It's okay. Now I will perform the virtual screen of these two compounds. I'll put here of these two compounds against that two molecular targets. Now I open the Octopus for the first time, and in first time you should install the Mopac. Okay, after you install the Mopac software, I suggest you to close the terminal and start again. It's necessary only for the first time to install Mopac. Well, as you can see, you can perform the optimization of the structure using RAM Mopac. I explained in previous video. You can perform VS Virtual Screen using RAM Mopac or without RAM Mopac or with RAM Mopac. I choose this one to explain the full process. You can now choose the automatic mode or manual mode. I will take this one to explain better. So, first we'll have to choose the ligands director. After the targets director, it will perform the refinement of the ligands using Mopac. You see the structs using Bimol. After the Octopus will generate BDBQT files. You can check again in Pymol, and after you perform the AutoDock Vina, and finally show you the results. Okay, on simulation, I have to choose the ligands. In the Octopus, you have a folder that you put. If you want, you can put your structures there, the ligands. But if you not, you can take anywhere from anywhere. Now I have to choose the targets directories. I will choose this one. Okay. It's to confirm. Now it will refine the structures using RAM Mopac into Octopus. In previous video, I explained. Okay. He's searching for errors. In this case, I don't have errors in my both structures. Not, there is no error. I talked about this in previous video as well. Now, if you can check the structures using PyMol. See, I have the structure of aspirin. It's okay. You can see all hydrogens here, the carboxylate group, okay? Indometacin, all hydrogens is okay. The structures were refinement. Now eu vou forward. Now he's prepared the PDBQT files. You can check again if you want. See, now you have only the hydrogen in polar atoms. In this case, you don't have any. And in this case, as well. Thus, the structures are okay. The PDBQT file, it's okay. Now, I go forward to docking. I'll make a pause to save time. He start to make the docking process using AutoDock Vienna. He finish one. He go to take the second structure, in this molecular targets. Please check our papers about the validation of our targets. I will make a pause to save time, but this project was supported by CNPq and FAPEMIG. On the doc calculation finish, here the last result of the last ligand and the molecular target, and you can see the results in two formas: an Excel table or format Excel only, and using HTML format. Virtual screen, experimental results. I perform using two ligands against two targets. It's the date and the time. As you can see, these two compounds can bind, can't not bind in these two molecular targets. Except this one, maybe it can bind in one PDX. Okay. But aspirin cannot bind in these two molecular targets. The less energy, more stronger the ligand bind in the target. And there is no erro in my ligands. Okay, these results are saved in the folder for you for to check if you want. So the octops. You have the results. You have the two formats, CSV and HTML format. Okay. The Octopus project was supported by CNPq and FAPEMIG. Thank you for your patience.